An important system that now appears as a method to prevent infections and also to prevent allergies is represented by the administration of probiotics during pregnancy. In fact, in the second and third trimesters of pregnancy, there is the possibility to colonize the mother and then to transmit the colonizing bacteria to the infants. It is quite interesting, this opportunity, because at the end, at birth, we have a microbiota that is acquired for the majority by the secretions of the mothers. And so the possibility to transmit positive bacteria is extremely important in this approach in the reduction of infections and in the reduction of allergies. On the other hand, we are always colonized by bacteria, and now we know that the microbiota is around 1.5 kilos of our body. So if we have this microbiota and we are able to condition in a positive way this bacteria, this can influence at the end the diseases that we had, and in the case of the infants, the potential diseases that the infants could have later in life. It has been demonstrated that the colonization of the infants at birth remained quite stable up to the age of 2 years. So for these reasons, these data are quite interesting and new. The results have been demonstrated for 4 different probiotic strains. First of all, Enterococcus faecium L3 that is able to colonize the mother, to reduce colonization due to bad pathogens, like for example Streptococcus agalactiae, and to reduce the risk of sepsis in the neonates and in the infants. So this is a benefit that has been demonstrated in the short term in terms of reduction of disease acquisition. Then the other point is represented by another strain that is Lactobacillus casei, that is able to produce tryptophan at the gastrointestinal level. And this tryptophan is converted in melatonin at the intestinal level, and the melatonin is able to reduce the intestinal motility. So this probiotic has a benefit for the mother in reducing abnormal intestinal motility, and is also very important in the infants in the first 3 months of life for abdominal pain. Then another benefit is given by Lactobacillus lactis that has an effect due to its 2 plasmides that are able, the first one, to produce an enzyme, lactase, that is able to convert the milk, and so to accept in a better way the milk. And then another enzyme that is a protease that is able to, again, convert some of the proteins included in the milk, and so to favor the absorption of the milk without problems like, for example, allergies or feeding intolerance. And finally, the other benefit is represented by the first strain, that is a Bifidobacterium BB12, that is able at the end to potentiate, for example, response to vaccines and to reduce the risk of respiratory infections in the first year of life, also with potential benefits in terms of allergy risk due to the modification of the cytokine response from a Th2 profile to a Th1 profile. So this means that in this way, with the administration of these first strains to the mother, we have the possibility to have some benefits in the mother and also to impact on the microbiota of the infants in order to obtain, of course and for sure, good results in short term and with high probability, potential benefits in medium and long term.